What's up, everyone? NeoScyther here, getting back to Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist Link Evolution, and here we go again. I was happy that Link to the Future was finally done after 11 attempts, but Bounty Hunter is the about the same thing. Whereas, it looks like I'm doing good, and then he comes back with one huge combo, and that's it. So this is my second attempt at this. Because the first attempt was going good until he pulled off one huge combo that pretty much screwed me over and wiped my field. Not a terrible opening hand. Jeez. That's a spell and trap remover was a thing in this game. So I know one of those is going to be called a Haunted. I might as well try to draw it out. Show me a call. Actually, yeah, what's crash? I'm okay with that. I'm okay with crashing. But the problem is, he has cards that can generate tokens. Some of his monsters can't be attacked unless. Okay. Stomp Boom destroys it. Okay, I can do this. Yep, let's get Bitron out of my hand. Gonna activate polymerization. Show me the other call. Oh. Okay, so till the end of my next turn, Cyber's Clock Dragon's the only thing that can attack. So let me double check that. Till the end of the next turn. So technically, I should be able to now. Let's gun some of this. So I'm only going to go into Honeybot. Get the Escaper back. Oh boy, which one am I going to here? Let's go Decode Talker. For Honey Boss, two materials, and Dotscaper. Okay. So far, so good. Naturally. That's all I've got. We're going to summon Ram Cloud here. Go to battle. Is this it? Okay, that is it. That wasn't quite as annoying as Varis's Rokket deck, Rokket Dragon deck. I mean, when Shepherd's deck gets going, it can be quite frustrating. I will say that. Well, in a sense, again, the first duel really showed off what his deck could do. Essentially, it's about generating tokens, and some of his monsters cannot be destroyed by battle if you control the token. Plus, a couple of his monsters, at least you can sack a token to gain 800 attack points for that turn. There's one that you can even sacrifice two tokens to target when your opponent's monsters and destroy it. So yeah, pretty annoying at times, but we have unlocked the next campaign duel, Blue Gals here. The reverse duel for the Bounty Hunter. The deck avatar for the Shepherd. The Shepherd's Mecha Phantom Flyer deck recipe. And the signature cards Great Fly, Mecha Phantom Beast Coltwing, Mecha Phantom Beast Erosguin. And 1,270 victory duel points. We have 100 points for the win, 16 points for a number of turns, 2 for activated spells, 15 for no traps, 4 for fusions, 12 for link summons, 7 for controlling a monster with high attack, 14 for maximum damage inflicted, 26 for different life points, and 10 for inflicting battle damage only for 206 points, if I can read. So yeah. No idea who we're doing as next. If we've already seen that person, I can't remember who that silhouette belongs to. Then again, I'm just doing my best to put Link to the Future out of my mind. Because, great pun in terms of the fact that there is no story in this game, so maybe Link to the Future would give us a future story, I don't know. And then it got overshadowed by how annoying the duel was. At least the Bounty Hunter was a bit of a refresher. With that, though, that's all I've got for this video. I thank you guys for watching. Hope you're enjoying the project so far, and I will see you next time.